Today, a three-man tribunal led by retired Justice Alice Mpaji Bahigeine ruled that NSSF takes over Temangalo land that came under scrutiny for alleged irregularities during its acquisition over 5 years ago. Others on the tribunal are retired Judge Stephen Ngwao and former MP Mike Sebalu. The tribunal was set up in March to arbitrate between Amos Nzei, the businessman who sold the land to NSSF, and the pensions body. At issue was the price of the land per acre and part of the land on which Nzei's house stands, which he claimed was not part of the deal. NSSF had taken it, given that this part of the land was also part of the transaction for the 435 acres it purchased from him in 2008. The tribunal held that the memorandum of understanding between businessman Amos Nzei and NSSF and the fact that 435 acreage land had been idle since the case started in 2008, the transaction led to a parliamentary probe over inflated pricing in the deal. Justice Mpaji held that it was wrong for the NSSF board to go against the MOU that NSSF signed with Nzei, which outlined what each had acquired. She also criticized the Solicitor General for his wrong advice in the matter.
The term of understanding has been defined by Black's Law Dictionary to be synonymous with a letter of intent. The ninth edition of this dictionary, page 988, defines a letter of intent to be a written statement detailing the preliminary understanding of the parties who plan to enter into a contract.
Businessman Amos Nzei welcomed the ruling, saying it has restored his reputation.
A happy moment for me, and I believe even my colleagues, the party to this case, they will be very happy. Yes.
The tribunal set up by the Minister of Finance began hearing the case in March this year. NSSF acquired the land in 2008 for a proposed housing estate without following the public procurement guidelines as stated in the PPDA Act. The NSSF acquired the land at 11 billion shillings then, which Parliament said was overrated. In the meantime, NSSF says they are ready to get the project on track.
And what the arbitration panel has said is let the parties abide by that negotiated settlement as communicated by the former board chair.
Over 5,000 housing units are expected to be put up on the land as part of the investments made for the serving members.